and welcome to the Community Kids Show. I am so glad you're here today. This is our first week of Brave. And for the next few weeks, we'll learn about what it means to be brave. And today, we're going to learn about a shepherd boy named David, who was chosen for a very special job. You know, every day we make lots of choices. So let's play a game that is all about choices. I'm going to give you two options and you shout out which you would choose. Would you choose the pool or the beach? How about cookies or cake? How about YouTube or Netflix? Hot dog or hamburger? Ice cream or snowball? How about Disney or Nickelodeon? You have very specific opinions, don't you? That's awesome. Those things are all really cool. Now, today, we're gonna hear about David, who was chosen to do a very special job. Now, David wasn't chosen by people around him. He was chosen by God for this special job. And just like David, we are also chosen by God to do something special. What God chooses for you might be different than what you would choose for you or what God chooses for other people to do. But you can have faith and believe that your special job is perfect just for you. Our big idea for today is God knows who I am. How about we go check in with our buddy Carl and hear more about our Bible story?
Hi there, you little chicken nuggets. We got a real exciting show for y'all today, so buckle up. Gonna be a bumpy ride.
Welcome to Grow TV. Introducing your host, Carl, and your co-host, Cassie, where we learn, where we grow, and we talk about Jesus. Once again, welcome to Grow TV.
Hi there, kiddos. I'm Carl.
And I'm Cassie. And boy, are we excited to hang out with all of you.
Hope y'all had an awesome day today, because I sure did. I discovered something real cool today.
What? That polar bears are left-handed?
What? No.
That all bees have hair on their eyes so they can collect pollen?
What are you talking about? No, that's frightening.
Okay, so what did you discover?
Well, I was walking down the street like this, you know, kind of like just swaying my arms and doing all that. And a man walked up to me and said, "Hey, are you a penguin?" And obviously, I said no.
Good answer.
And then he came back and said, "Why not?" And I said, "Well, I'm not a penguin. I'm a human. And humans can't be penguins."
That makes sense.
Right? That would be ridiculous. But at that moment, he raised his hand and slapped me on the cheek. And he said, "You can be anything you want." And it was at that moment I had an epiphany.
Epiphany?
Zoot time.
Okay, so what was your epiphany?
I can be anything I want.
What do you mean, like for a job?
No, I can be anything I want. I mean, who says I can't be a penguin?
I'm not sure I follow. I mean, are you taking advice from the guy who slapped you?
Yeah.
What happened after he slapped you?
Well, nothing. He slapped me and then walked away backwards. It's kind of weird.
Okay, well, it's interesting advice, but what do you want to be?
Well, part of me wants to be cool, dangerous, mysterious, but most importantly, different.
Different? Why?
Well, I feel like when I read the Bible, I read stories about people who had really big, unique, defining qualities about them. So if I could have something different about me, maybe God can recognize me as someone special.
I don't know.
So here we go. I've created some characters and I want to see what you think, okay?
All right.
Hello, my name is Ivan and I ride polar bear. Oi! How about you and me go through some logs and eat some haggis for freedom? Hello! My name is Bobby Callahan III. Fancy some tea, do you? High society. Out of there, Tex. Who's up for some catfish and wrestling some gators? Yeah!
Hey, girl. I'm cool.
That's not good.
I know that, but I'm trying, okay?
All right, well, I just
what?
Think...
What do you think? I'm acting my heart out here, Cassie. I want to be different. I want God and others to know who I am.
I understand, I just... Have you ever heard of a King David?
Is that the cereal guy?
That's Cap'n Crunch.
So, not the same?
No, completely different. He was an important person in the Old Testament.
Really? He sounds cool.
He was, and God had a big plan for him. You see, at that time, God's people wanted a king simply because other nations had a king.
And the one they got, King Saul, didn't love God like he should have.
Well, that's a bummer.
It was, so God told Samuel to find the king that God wanted.
Wait, who's Samuel?
Samuel was a man whose name meant the Lord hears. He was chosen by God to become a prophet, and he did a lot of good for a lot of people.
That's awesome.
Yep, so Samuel went to meet the man that God was going to name the new king of Israel. And he went to a house of a man named Jesse. Samuel met all of Jesse's sons and still didn't meet the one that God had picked.
So did God make a mistake?
Nope, Jesse had one more son that was out taking care of his sheep. Want to guess what his name was?
Captain Crunch.
Nope, that's cereal. Want to try again?
Yeah, I know this. I know this. David. It was David.
You got it. So David was the youngest of the brothers, and it was right then when Samuel anointed David to be the next king.
So he was the youngest brother?
Yep.
Wow, I figured he'd be the oldest, strongest, and coolest brother. Something that made him different.
Well, you know what made him special?
A cool accent?
Nope.
Superhuman strength?
Nope.
I got nothing.
His heart.
His heart? What about his heart? Was it gold or something?
No, Carl. God knew his heart, and God knew he would make a great king.
Wow. So that's what made him different, huh?
Yes, we must always remember that God calls every single one of us to be brave and do amazing things. And we can never forget that God knows who you are and God knows who I am.
Wow, that's so cool. That almost sounds like our big idea. Wait a minute, that is our big idea. Today's big idea is God knows who I am.
And on the count of three, we're gonna say it out loud together, okay?
Ready?
Ready.
One, two, three, God knows who I am! What a big idea. You did it.
So do you feel better now knowing that God knows who you are?
I sure do.
Good, so you can stop with the silly voices now, right?
Absolutely. Unless it's a tad bit boring and I have to jump into another accent. Tally-ho, children!
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of RoTV!
Sometimes, when God asks us to do something, we are afraid because of what might happen. That's a chance for us to trust God. Now, the job that God chose David for was not an easy one. And remember, David was pretty young too. He didn't have a lot of experience doing what God chose him to do, but God knew David was the perfect choice. And God knows who you are too. God has chosen special things for you to do. God knows who we are better than anyone else. Samuel and David's dad probably never would have picked David because he was the youngest child, but God knew who David was, and God knows who we are. And he sees greatness in all of us, and he sees the potential that we have. So let's pause for a moment and let's talk to God. Let's thank him for creating us the way that he did. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for the way that you created us. Thank you for designing us to do special things. Guide us to accomplish those special things that you have called us to do. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, friends, let's practice our Bible memory verse for this month, and it comes from Isaiah 41:10. And it says, "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God." Let's try that one more time. It's Isaiah 41:10. And it says, "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God." Great job, everyone. All right, that's all from me here. I'm going to pass you off to Pastor Jason for some worship. We'll see you all later.
Hey guys, it's Pastor Jason again. And what was our big idea for today? Do you guys remember it? It was God knows who I am. It's pretty simple. God knows who I am. Think about that. The God of the universe knows exactly who we are because he created us. So we're going to sing and learn the motions to a song called Known, which talks about exactly that. So get up on your feet and get ready to sing along and do the motions to this song.
You see right through the mess inside me. And you call me out to pull me in. You tell me I can start again. And I don't need to keep on hiding. I'm fully known in love by you. You won't let go. No matter what I do. And it's not one or the other. It's hard truth and ridiculous grace to be known.